Boston, Massachusetts, March 2018. Nectome, a biotechnology startup company, announces an audacious and controversial plan. Their vision? A groundbreaking technique that can take the data stored inside a human brain and transfer it into a computer.
There are companies like Nectome that are attempting to preserve the brain and the mind. Our methods of analyzing the connections between neurons in the brain are getting really good. And so eventually we'll be able to model the connections between all the neurons. And at that point, we'll have a better idea as to whether or not it's possible to upload a brain into the cloud. But we'll have to wait and see what happens.
Uploading is the process of basically copying and encoding someone's mental life onto a computer. Advocates of uploading believe that that would really be a way for you to survive the death of your brain.
And now people say, well, if I'm immortal and I'm living my life inside a computer, isn't that rather boring? No, because this mainframe computer will connect to a mechanical avatar that is superhuman in every way, and you will see through its eyes, you'll feel through its sense organs. So in other words, we will have a form of digital immortality.
Digital immortality, the incredible notion that we might someday be able to live forever. But if the information inside our brains can be copied and transferred, like information onto a computer hard drive, does that mean it can keep and store everything? Like our personalities, perhaps? Or would something be lost in translation?
There are two issues to consider here. First of all, why believe that a digital copy of you is capable of being conscious? The second issue is that it doesn't at all follow that that being would really be you, that you are the survivor rather than a digital copy.
Consciousness is one of the most hard to define phenomena about the human brain, and it's also what separates us from all other species. It's this idea that we have internal reflection. Can we actually live on forever in a computer and still be able to preserve all our memories, all our friendships, all of the different things that we love? And I think that that's a very romantic notion for a lot of people, that they want to feel like there's a way to go on forever. But you can't separate the brain from the rest of your body.
There are those who believe the human brain has more potential than even the brain itself can imagine, and that its true capabilities might be limitless. In some ways, we know more about the far reaches of the galaxy than we do about the human mind.